Hi, everybody. This is Dave Levine, and welcome to another edition of the Boxes Near Me Business Minute. Be sure to visit boxesnearme.com for the biggest deals in boxes, period. Getting down to business. You know what? Karma is a fickle bitch. Today, we are seeing the arrest by the FBI of Martin Schkreli. Who is Martin Schkreli? Well, he was the former hedge fund manager slash CEO of Turing Pharmaceuticals, who decided to buy a little-known HIV drug and raise the price from $13 to $14 to around $750 a dose, causing a huge amount of outrage. What is this greedy, evil, you know, capitalist doing right now? Well, let's see. He's apparently been accused of falsifying the performance of his hedge fund, falsifying the performance figures, shuffling money between his different funds to pay different debts that he owes, and all kinds of financial manipulations dealing with securities fraud and misrepresentation. Basically, the truth of the matter is he's just a punk, and he is going to have to go to jail because he just thinks he's, you know, the king of everything, and he really doesn't care how he makes money, and now he's not going to be making any money. Well, he might be making a few pennies a day cleaning dishes, you know, in the commissary, but other than that, I don't think he's going to be doing very well. In other news, speaking of money, Connor McGregor is rumored to be potentially the first $100 million athlete for the UFC. Not so much the fight purses, but like the gate draws that he gets, you know, $10, $12 million a fight, the endorsements, possibly the movie deals, you know, cross-licensing, licensing, all these things. $100 million. Now, that's assuming that Conor McGregor can maintain this unbelievable, you know, record that he has. But the fact of the matter is he's going to make, I believe, over $10 million off of his previous fight alone. So, yeah, I mean, there is a huge amount of drawing power for Conor McGregor. And, you know, while some people might argue that his antics and sort of belligerent comments aren't the greatest thing in the world for the sport, I personally think it's entertaining. And I know that it takes a lot longer than 13 seconds to learn how to fight like that. So good luck to Conor McGregor. Finally, for the first time in many, many years, Federal Reserve has decided yesterday to increase interest rates by 0.25%. Now, what does that really mean? What that really means is that the Fed is still keeping interest rates artificially low. There is still no really good alternative place to put your money besides, you know, risk assets at, such as the stock market or real estate or assets that will increase in value because there's no alternative. In other words, what I'm trying to say is this doesn't really change anything. All it does is continue the artificial type stimulation that our government has started many, many years ago to ward off a thing called deflation. They're afraid that we're going to slip into a Japanese scenario, which they've been in for 30 years, where basically the economy's in the toilet because, you know, assets are decreasing in price. And it's what it does when everything decreases in price. It's as if, well, okay, today I'm not going to buy something because tomorrow I think it's going to be cheaper. And it keeps people from buying, period. They only buy things when necessary, not when they want them. And so that's why deflation is very dangerous. And that's why the Fed is doing what they're doing. Still, you have to figure that there will be consequences to printing all this money and keeping these interest rates artificially low. In the meantime, you have to figure that the stock market will continue to go up, real estate will continue to go up, and people will continue to buy things that they don't need. But they do need boxes. So if you need boxes, come on down to Boxes Near Me, 480-332-0844. We work by appointment. Have a great day.